Thank you.
We want to welcome you to the International Hotel. It's nice to see you. I'm just looking you over. Look good. How old are you? Come on. 15? Where are these people? How are they getting into this midnight show here? The filth show. Didn't anyone tell you this is our filth show? That's why you're here. Your father hadn't spoken to you about filth yet? Yeah? And that's why you're here. I see. You want to learn more filth. Yeah. Well, you'll never learn nothing here. Open your Bibles to page 7. Where are you from? Lancaster. Oh, yeah? Okay, not far from my hometown. Filthadelphia. Getting back to the other thing. People in this hotel are very, very nice. They've just been groovy, groovy cats. Everybody here has. They gave me a suite here, you know. I have a big time suite. Oh, yeah, man. Weird, though. Weird suite. They got a mirror over my bed. No, I swear, there's a big mirror over my bed. And I looked, I said, well, wait a minute. And I was uneasy going to sleep. I had a feeling the pit boss was watching me. Weird, no? When I sleep, I toss and turn and everything, man. And I woke up in the morning like this, you know, and looked up. Geez, I thought it was a naked skydiver coming up. But it's fun, though, when you have a mirror over your bed. You can watch yourself get in the bed. Yeah, I like that. It's cool. I'm used to it now. Everyone, I look at myself. Yeah. But I don't know what it's there for. I really don't. I have no idea. It's silly to have a mirror over your bed. You gonna shave in bed? What the hell are you gonna watch? All I know is from the way I get a broken neck trying to watch. And Camille's virgin Catholic. I know she ain't peeking. Come forth with a pro-wife, pro-woman album. Has nothing to do with women's lib. Has to do with identification. Mainly because I've seen a lot of husbands and the way they treat their wives, and it's just not cool at all. I mean, especially when you think about what's going on out there, gambling. We just talk about gambling, period. Now, what you're after is their dollars. Okay. But I happen to know from years of working here that it's all on their side. And if you don't think it is, then just go out there and see where all the money is. I mean, they make their own chips, let's face it. We don't make our own money. And they're just the opposite of us. They got all their money laid right out there so you can see it. And greed jumps right on your head. I want everything in that rack. And they say, you can have it. But, that's a heavy but. That's the heaviest but you'll ever see in your life. Yes, Lord, they're ready for us. And we got everything on our side, too. I never heard so many people calling on God and Jesus. Ain't neither one of us getting answered. No way, shape, or form. I tell you why. Because everybody's calling on God and Jesus for something.
Oh, God, let me have an 8. Let me have a 6. Let me have a 10 down on that double down. Please, God, if you just...
You multiply that by all the people playing and begging and all those numbers coming up at the same time. You know God can't figure out who to send what to what.
So God just says, bust everybody. And you know they're not worried about us out there. Have you seen one cross out there? You never heard one pit boss say, oh God, don't let him make another pass. Never. But you hear us begging God to death and won't even go to church on Sunday or go to the synagogue on Saturday either if we're winning. God will understand. Yes, God. You just can't do it. Just can't do it. Since you cannot do it, why beat on your wife? I mean, mentally and physically. Why beat on her? She's only trying to save you from losing everything you have. And you know if your wife wasn't here, you'd drop a whole load. And if she's going to be a pain in the behind, let her be it. And they are, too. They walk right along with you.
You're going to lose everything, ain't you? You're going to lose everything. Tell the truth. Ain't you going to lose everything?
Well, you get away from me before I kill you.
Yeah, but you've already lost $25, and then you put that... What? You put all that money down. I told you not to do it.
Hey, you get away from me, I'll punch you out.
Now, that's the woman you married. That's the woman you married. Now, let's break it down. Let's take a look at it. When you got married, standing there waiting for her to come down the aisle, she came down and you looked at her and you said, gee whiz, she's coming. She's coming down there for me. And you were so happy she was doing that little walk. And you got your best buddies hooked up like that, too. They're coming down the aisle. Everybody walking like they're in a horror picture or something. Who made up that walk anyway? When I got married, we just went on down and said, are you here? Yeah, you better believe it. We didn't have a whole bunch of, do you take this woman to be whatever, whatever? I said, no, I just said, you want her? Yeah, you got her. Tippest wedding in the world. But don't do that to your wife. And it ain't worth it. Because look, after you lose all your money, she's all you got left. And who wants an angry wife when you're broke? I got it all figured out.